his son reign instead. And Amaziah, the son of Joash, king of Judah, lived after death of Joash, the son of Jehoiakim, king of Israel 15 years. And the rest of the acts of Amaziah, are they not written in the book of Chronicles in the kings of Judah? Now they made a conspiracy against him in Jerusalem, and he fled to Lachish. But they sent after him to Lachish and slew him there. And they brought him on horses, and he was buried in Jerusalem with his fathers in the city of David. And all the people of Judah took Azariah, which was 60 years old, and made him king instead of his father Amaziah. And he built Elath and restored it unto Judah. After that, the king slept with his father. In the 15th year of Amaziah, the son of Joash, king of Judah, Jeroboam, the son of Joash, king of Israel, began to reign in Samaria. And he reigned 41 years. And he did that which was evil in the sight of the Lord. He departed not from all of his sins of Jeroboam, the son of Nebat, who made Israel to sin. He restored the coast of Israel from entering of Hamath under the sea of plain, according to the word of the Lord God of Israel, which he spake by the hand of the servant Jonah, the son of Amittai, the prophet, which was a Gath of fear. For the Lord saw the affliction of Israel, that it was very bitter, for there was not any shut up, nor any left, nor any helper from Israel. And the Lord said not that he would blot out the name of Israel from under heaven, but he saved them by the hand of Jeroboam, the son of Joash. Now the rest of the acts of Jeroboam, and all that he did, and his might, and how he wars, and how he recovered Damascus, and Hamath, which belongeth, amen, to Judah for Israel, are they not written in the book of the Chronicles of the kings of Israel? And Jeroboam slept with his fathers, even the kings of Israel, and Zechariah, his son, reigned in his stead. You see what happens, amen, when the wicked start ruling and reigning, and take it over it and stopping the things of God. Amen. Used to be. Amen. I heard a story this morning where a street preacher in Louisiana, amen, was arrested, put in jail for preaching the word of God. Now they come back and said they done it falsely. Didn't take a rocket scientist. Everybody made it. Didn't have to figure that one out, brother. Perry Mason didn't need to be called in on that one. A man ought to be winning America today. I mean, they can march up and down the streets today with rags tied around their heads. Amen. Blow our boys up in a foreign country, and we got to allow freedom. And a man of God's arrested for preaching the gospel on the streets of this nation that we let God for. I'm telling you today, friend, it's wrong. It's backward, and it must change. It must change. And if it don't change, you'll see a change. You know what? Today I sound like an alien from another country. Give me a day coming. So children will say, I remember going to church when I was 16 years old. I remember an old-time preacher man preaching when they had on a black shirt and a pair of black galluses. I remember him preaching about that very thing, telling us it was coming. I remember being in Sunday school and hearing my teacher down 3 years tell that they wouldn't doubt that in 10 or 15 years that certain things would be happening. Buddy, it would be 5 years for those things to start coming, and you never even think about it. I told you that I want the music to come to the platform. Just tell you a story that I've heard all my life, or since I've been in church. I'll say. It's a story about a frog. And the frog, they told about how that you can put a pan of boiling water on the stove and pitch a frog in it, and it doesn't kill it, he'll jump out of it. But it also says that you can put a pan of water on, put a frog in it, and turn it on low, and he'll stay in there until he's cooked because he doesn't jump out. And that sort of sounds like today what's happening in our society. By the time we've gotten the cold water and the heat's been turned up real slow, and we've gotten used to the dark, and we don't say too much about it no more. We don't say a thing about it. We just let it go. We just want to dream and tell everybody that's not really happening. That's not the way it is. No, we didn't see that. We didn't see that young boy or that young girl do no such as that. We're not hearing those things today, but we are. We are. And it's happening right here in the good old U.S. of A. A nation that I love more than any breadbasket of the world, but yet it's happening right here. I say to you today, it's time that we do something about it. It's time we repent and turn to God. It's time we give our lives to Jesus Christ and start obeying His voice and start hearing His call as He calls us. And start listening. Would you bow your head this morning and say, get ready to sing? Heavenly Father, I want to thank you. I want to thank you for the story of this man, Jonah. Lord, that you didn't let him be destroyed. God, you preserved him. You brought him through. And Lord, thank you for hearing the prayer of the people in Nineveh. You spared them. But Lord, will we repent? Will our nation turn back to you? Will our churches begin to turn back to you? Will our families begin to turn back to you? Father, I just ask you to touch them. Help us. Help us. If you will, Lord, just help us. We praise you, Jesus. Amen. What they say, we've never seen a time that the American home is under such an attack like it is right now. Homes are breaking up at an all-time high. Families tossed from pillar to post. Families don't know what to do, where to turn. The economy's took a downturn. People have lost their jobs. People can't pay for their houses. It's brought a stress and a pressure upon this nation. What will we do? Listen, if you lose everything you've got, don't lose Jesus. If you turn to everything in this world, don't turn him away. You need him more than you need life itself. Stand your feet this morning. Stand your feet. I want to ask a question. If you're in this building and you've never been saved, or you're a backslider, you're out of the will of God, I want you to step out. I'm going to give you 1 minute to come. I'm not going to wear the patience of everybody in this building. If you want to come and pray, we're going to pray with you. We're going to seek God's face. Will you come?